As I said, this is strictly not a parable, but a truncated Matthew 24 continuation of that Matthew 24 prophecy, because we have the event after the parousia. So we read there in verse 31-32. To me, that's a fulfillment of Daniel 7, the famous, the saints of the Most High, the Son of Man figure that Daniel sees on the clouds or riding in the cloud, coming to or ascending to the Ancient of Days, and then how the nations are portrayed as beasts, the whole judgment, the fulfillment of Joel 3 and Matthew 13. So as you note here, this is once again Jehovah Yahweh, God the Father, speaking. He's doing this, right? He's the king. He's the judge. So note, right, in Matthew 25, he's the Son of Man. That's Daniel 7. And now the Son of Man transforms into the king. That's a very important transition. When Jesus is in the Sanhedrin, if you remember, when he's being tried in the what I call a kangaroo court, he's asked repeatedly, are you the Son of Man? Tell us clearly, you know, stop messing with us. And he says, yes, I am. And then he says, and you will see me. He's the Son of Man, used, by the way, 80 times throughout the Gospels. That's Jesus' favorite self-designation. Why? Because he is the human being. He's not the God-man, the God-human. No, he's the supreme human being on the Daniel vision. Here, let's read this in the traditional way, in the majority way. All the nations, verse 32, let's say all the Christians will be gathered. So you have good Christians and bad Christians. And then they're judged according to what they did to other fellow Christians. That's unlikely, if not unusual language for Jesus to use, an unusual judgment criteria here being used. The Israel of God in the Old Testament or Christians in the New Testament, they're never described as the nations. But people from the nations that do meet God's criteria, in other words, people who without knowing did well to Christians, there is precedent that for those, what I call redeemed non-Christians, there is precedent that they're described with Christian blessings, inherit the kingdom prepared before the world, and so on.